If you import your pixel art inside Unity, then it's going to look awful. So let's try to fix that. First of all, we have to define the pixels per unit. This has to be the same for every single sprite that you have inside your project. So select all your sprites, and I'm going to give it 16, which is going to be, for example, my goblin is 16 pixels tall. So a pixel per unit of 16 is going to make my goblin exactly one unit tall. Next up, to get rid of the blurriness, we have to select point no filter for the filter mode, and select none for the compression. And this way our sprites are looking much nicer, but we still have a problem which might not be obvious. If we take a look at the goblin, for example, you can see that both of its eyes are one pixel, but inside Unity one of its eyes is narrower than the other, and some of its pixels are wider than other pixels. And if I try to move him around, we can see how this changes and the different pixels are getting wider or narrower as I move him. This shouldn't happen, and this is happening because our sprite is scaled by a non-integer value, and pixel art sprites can only ever be scaled by whole numbers. If you scale them by fraction numbers like 1.5, for example, then they won't look right. So in order to get rid of this problem, first of all, we have to check that each of our sprites has a scale that is an integer number. My goblin here has a scale of one unit. That's perfect. Next up, the scale up here in the game window should be also an integer. And we have to define a resolution, a target resolution. With the plus icon here, you can add a new one, a fixed resolution. I have already done that. I'm going to select it and change the scale back to 1. And this is all the setup that we need. Now the only thing that we have to change is the camera's size. The camera's size is equal to the number of vertical units divided by 2. So if I go back to the scene view here, each of these squares represents one unit. So if I have, for example, a camera size of 5, then we are going to have 10 units vertically. And we can count them right here. The white square is the boundary of our camera. So what happens here is, if I have 10 vertical units and my resolution height is 720, so we have 720 pixels vertically and 10 units vertically, So those 720 pixels are going to be split across these 10 units. So if we get a calculator and we divide 720 by 10, the number of units, then we get 72 pixels. Each unit here is going to contain 72 pixels vertically, which means that our sprites won't be displayed correctly because we have set our sprites to have 16 pixels per unit. We have 72 pixels per unit in this setup, which means that our sprites are going to be scaled. And by how much? We can quickly calculate that. So we have 72 pixels per unit with this resolution and camera size setup. We divide that by the pixels per unit of our sprites, the PPU for short, which is 16, and we get 4.5. So our sprites are getting scaled by 4.5, which is not an integer number. So this is why our sprites are not rendering pixel perfectly. So let's try and find a camera size that would give us a scale that is an integer number, because in that case, all of our sprites are going to be rendered perfectly. So our resolution in this case is 1280 by 720 and our sprites have a PPU of 16. I put here the definition of the camera size, and let's divide the height in pixels by our PPU and we get 45, which gives us a camera size of 22.5. So if we have a camera size of 22.5, then we are going to have exactly 16 pixels per unit. And our sprites are going to have a scale of 1. Let's try that out. So I'm going to give my camera a size of 22.5. Now, in this case, our sprites are quite tiny, so I'm going to use the scale. I'm going to scale up the game window, but this has to be also an integer number, so I'm going to scale it up to 4, let's say. And now, if I move my goblin, he is rendered perfectly. Every pixel that he has the same size, and it's not twitching around if I move him. Alright, I'm going to change back the scale to 1. And we are done. Now we can either scale our sprites individually with this, with their transform that scale property. You have to use integer numbers here as well, so I can, for example, scale up my goblin, or if we want all of our sprites to be bigger, then we, instead of scaling up every sprite, what we can do is choose a smaller camera size, because smaller camera sizes mean that we have less units vertically, and our sprites are going to be scaled more. So what we can do is we have our magical camera size right here, 22.5. What we can do is divide this camera size by any integer. So we can divide it by 2, 3 or 4, for example. And then we are going to get a different scale. So in case of 22.5, our sprites are getting scaled by 1. They have a scale of 1. If we divide this by 2, so if we have a camera size of 11.25, then that means that we have twice as many vertical units, which is 22.5 vertical units. And if I divide 720, which is our height in pixels, by 22.5 units, then we get that with a camera size of 11.25, each unit is going to contain 32 pixels, which means that all of our sprites are going to have a scale of 2. So if I put in as a camera size of, if I put in 11.25 as the camera size, then all of our sprites are going to be bigger. This is also a little too small for my game. So let's put in 7.5 and let's see how that looks. It's still quite small, so I'm going to put in 5.625. 5.625. And I'm happy with this size, and let's check if our sprites are still rendering perfectly. And if I move my goblin around, you can see that everything looks nice and crispy. Alright, that's really all you need to know about pixel perfect rendering. If I lost you somewhere in the explanation, you can check out Unity's blog post on the same topic. I'm going to link that in the description of this video. And thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day.